In the past few videos, we've been working with the monotone convergence theorem and its consequences. The idea behind working with those type of theorems was that integrating functions is very, very difficult, and we usually will avoid doing it. So to see if the integral of a function is finite or infinite, we were going to use approximations and convergence theorem, such as the monotone convergence theorem. Now, we're going to work with another very important and very strong theorem called Fatou's Lemma. Before we start, let me remind you that if you're finding these videos helpful and you want to support the channel, you can donate with the link in the description of the video on Ko-fi. Your support helps us grow the channel and bring more videos like this one. Let's start with the Lemma. It says that we have any sequence of non-negative measurable functions, and it allows us to compare with a less than or equal to the integral of the inferior limit and the inferior limit of the integral. I know, when you look at this, it might look a bit weird. I mean, we just work with the monotone convergence theorem that was beautiful. It had the function here and equal and the limit here. And now we have all these inferior limits. It might seem awful, but let me convince you that it's actually amazing. First of all, for the monotone convergence theorem, we had one sequence that was increasing and that it converged to another function. Now we have just any sequence. So we just graph any sequence of functions. And then also, and the second thing that makes this great is that here we have the inferior limit and the inferior limit. So because we're graphing just any sequence of functions, the limit may not even exist. Well, this gives us a way to bound the inferior limit of the integral, and we will see in more detail why this can be very helpful and very beneficial when we work on a few exercises. And yes, it might seem like a drawback that here you have a less than or equal to instead of an equal to, but usually all we care about is whether this integral is finite or infinite. We're not usually interested in calculating the exact value of the integral. So inequalities such as this one are extremely useful anyway. The rest of this video is going to be devoted to proving Fatou's lemma, so if you're not interested in knowing the proof, you can skip to the next one. However, I recommend that you stick for the proof. It's very short and it will give us a tool that might be used later on. The idea for this proof is to try and decompose this inferior limit into two parts. First of all, you have the inferior limit of any sequence is the supremum of the infimum. So let's define hk, a function of x, as the second part of this inferior limit, that is, the infimum over all the n greater than k of the sequence fn of x. So you look at a particular x and you see for all these functions which one is the smallest one. You just take the infimum. So it's immediate from this that hk of x will be less than or equal to fk of x. This is trivial because, well, this infimum, it could be the fk, but in particular it could be any f n for n greater than k. So because hk is the infimum over all this family, then in particular here we can just say that h is going to be smaller than fn for any n greater than or equal to k. Now because we have this, then we can integrate on both sides and have that the integral of hk the mu is less than or equal to the integral of f the mu, again for every n greater than or equal to k. So we have these inequalities valid for all these n's, and in particular then we have that the integral of hk the mu is less than or equal to the infimum of these integrals, because it's smaller than all of this, so it has to be smaller than the infimum. Well, let's just say this equation is going to be useful in a few minutes. Let's think for a minute about our functions. Let me write again. Hk is the infimum of fn. So what happens if I take k1 smaller than or equal to k2? What happens with h of k1 and h of k2? Well, if we imagine here we have k1 and here k2, just two integers, then h of k1 is going to take the infimum over all the n greater than or equal to k1. So the infimum is going to be here, but hk2 is going to take the infimum over all the n's greater than k2, so it's only going to be an infimum on this region. So the set where we're taking the infimum for k1 is greater than the set where we're taking for k2. So it has more chances of being smaller. And so h of k1 will always be less than or equal to h of k2. So hk is an increasing sequence. And, well, I wonder what happens with the limit when k tends to infinity of hk. Well, taking this limit is the same as taking the supremum over k of hk. But if we remember, hk is the infimum over all the n's greater than k. So we have the supremum of the infimum of fn. Well, this is just the inferior limit of fn. So we have an increasing sequence with limit this function, inferior limit of fn. This tells us that we can use the monotone convergence theorem with hk. Well, let's do that. We want to prove the integral of the inferior limit less than the inferior limit of the integral. So let's start with this left-hand side and see what we get. The integral of the limit of fn. Well, we just said this limit is just the limit of hk, so this is the limit of hk, and now I'm taking the integral of a limit of an increasing sequence. Well, the monotone convergence theorem says that we can pull the limit out of the integral. So this is going to be equal to the limit when k tends to infinity of the integral of hk. But now we have an integral of hk, and we said that this integral was smaller than or equal to the infimum of the integrals of fn. So let's use this. So using asterisk, we get that this is less than or equal to, we have the limit, and each of these integrals is less than or equal to the infimum of n greater than or equal to k of the integral of fn. Well, but now I have the limit when k tends to infinity of the infimum of n greater than k. Well, that is just the inferior limit when n tends to infinity of these integrals. And like this, we were able to prove that the integral of the inferior limit is less than or equal to the inferior limit of the integrals. Don't worry too much about the proof itself. What was useful in this proof was defining this family of functions, hk, as the infimum of fn. And we know that we can integrate these functions, so this is allowed because each of the functions hk is measurable. We proved this in a previous video. The infimum of a sequence of measurable functions is measurable. And so we just use the monotone convergence theorem conveniently to get Fatou's lemma.